So here is the Sydney Opera House with the vesicopisces shapes, the vaginal shapes, the leading into the wombs of creation. At night the lights come on and you can see the light within the womb, or coming from the womb of creation. The Opera House sits on the harbour, at the waters, the water being a female element. The word opera in Latin means work and effort. You might recognise that in words such as operate and operable.
The word opus is a noun. It can be used to describe a work of music or sets of work with a specified rank in an ordering of a composer's complete published works. It can also describe a work, especially of art. The painter's last opus was a dedication to all things living, in a surprising contrast to all of his prior work. The reason that I've brought up the etymology of opera and opus is to highlight the idea that from within the vesicopisces, within the womb of creation, if you will, that there are works, operations, creative processes happening, magnum opuses, great works coming out of the womb of creation.
If we look at this cover of a Freemason magazine, we can see a boy scout in this case, on the Opera House, using the horn, blowing that horn on top of the Opera House. So there we have the male aspect on top of the female aspect. Now, within a very close proximity, as one would expect, there is perhaps the male aspect, and that would be in none other than the god Pan. So let's now have a look at the god Pan that is right next to the Opera House. So here we have Pan, the horny god Pan, the male aspect, the male generative aspect, with his position and his horns right beside the female Opera House. Now you may think this is a coincidence. If that's the case, let's see if we can find another coincidence. In the garden here, we have the vesicopisces shape over and over again. The vesicopisces shape is replete everywhere. Vesicopisces shape is everywhere around Darling Harbour. It's within the IMAX Theatre, particularly if we have a look from the top. Here is the Vesicopisces shape up here, and here it is in the Home nightclub as well.
So within the womb of the home nightclub, many a hormone gets released as intoxicated patrons enjoy sexual excitement and union, perhaps reminding us of that horny god Pan. And yes, he is very close by. So we will now enter the complex off Sussex Street, Darling Park, Tower 2.
So this is the Darling Park complex of buildings outside Darling Harbour. It's designed by a company called Civic Arts, and their attention to detail is just incredible. Throughout this building there are many, many Vesicopisces shapes which may become apparent even as we walk into the building with many other shapes. But if we walk into the front of the building here, speaking of Vesicopisces shapes, we can see none other than the horny god Pan. Just as we could see outside the Opera House. So, there we have it. Now if I pan around, we'll see some more horns over here, very, very close to the Opera House, and I will show you those very soon. So within the Darling Park complex here, there is a lot of symbology, and as we can see on the wall here, here is the god Pan, the horny god Pan. He's actually carrying a bottle in one hand.
So I'm entering the vaginal-esque, Vesicopisces-like doorway of St. Andrew's Cathedral. Spot the Vesicopisces with the light coming forth at the other end of the church. I hope you enjoyed the presentation. I intend to create a longer version with a tad more esoteric detail. But please rate, comment, and subscribe.